Hi, my name is Ian Van Tuyl, and this is a video walkthrough for the 2013 Jeanneau 57. This particular vessel we're going to be delivering today, this afternoon, and then I'm going to be accompanying my clients from San Diego here up to Ventura, Oxnard, Channel Islands area. So we're going to have a great sail ahead of us, and hopefully going to bring you some footage as well. But let me tell you a little bit about this particular vessel, and as you can see it in the pre-delivery stages. Starting up here at the bow, we have a really nice plum bow. We have a double bow anchor roller set up front. This is the Facnor electric furling system. It's a phenomenal touch to add ease of handling of a vessel of this size. As we come back, you're going to notice we have a really nice continuous tow rail. The tow rail has really nice entry cleats going to the cleats itself. So depending on which way you tie up your vessel, you get the proper lead going to the cleats with the proper load factor. The factors of pulling a cleat sideways limits all of its strength, but when you pull it in a directional area, this adds great strength to the vessel. And this also has a really nice finish. You're going to see this really nice low profile cabin top design. This is a Philippe Brion naval architect design. He designs a lot of really high-end super mega yachts. Also, he does the C&B line, Perini Nave, and a lot of other off vessels, but a really phenomenal design, phenomenal naval architect. As you can see here, we have a custom Dodger by Memo's Custom Canvas here in San Diego. We have a really nice sleek look. This is the strato glass, so it's really thick and really hard, giving you a really nice visual through it. We have the stainless steel grab handles, the connector to the bimini. This particular bimini, we designed it so it will collapse up. Also in the connector, which is kind of unique, we've added two windows here for the people who can look up at the mainsail, and then two above each helm. So you get good visual of your sails when the connector's up. As you can see, we have our congratulations sign today, so when they come down to see their vessel for the first time, they're really welcomed by the cruising yachts and Jeanneau crowd. Here's the transom of the vessel. We rolled out the red carpet. We have the phenomenal dinghy garage here. This will house lots of storage, also your dinghy. The dinghy itself, you can house up to a 9.5 foot, 10 foot dinghy inflated. Anything above that, you're going to have to deflate. What makes that easy is this high volume air compressor right here. So you can deflate and inflate the dinghy from this air compressor. This comes with hoses and adapters and so forth. So a really nice touch. We have the swim step shower, hot and cold, located right here on the transom of the vessel. All of our navigation lights and interior lighting is all LED, so very low consumption on that. As you can see, our little pretty bow here as you enter the vessel. And then we have all of the cockpit cushions and everything laid out and ready to go. All of our instrumentation is all set up and on right now. This is new for 2013 is the throttle location. It was lower down here, but then they moved it up to this point. And then they've also moved the engine cluster gauges at the base of the cockpit table. Just above this is our Raymarine E140. A GPS plotter. This has a radar overlay and a lot of good features about this. Great visibility, a large screen, easy to handle and access. We have our VHF RAM mic that's here, so we have full control of our VHF right here in the cockpit. And then all of our switches are all labeled for our nav lights and so forth. This vessel also has the German sheeting. It's a double-ended main sheet, so you have a dedicated electric winch for the main sheet here in the back, with a fast and slow speed control, and then also for the general winch that's located here. So at both helms, you can operate the main and the jib, along with the electric furling switch. This is a great setup for shorthanded. One thing that we did after the fact is we added another electric furling switch to the port helm here. This will give us control of our head sail from either helm as well. So from the factory, they just do it to starboard, but this is a really nice, easy addition to bring it over here to the port helm as well. So as you can see, we have a phenomenal cockpit here. The cockpit itself is just untouchable of any vessel out there, 60 foot and below. Large cockpit table with leafs. The leafs themselves are all louvered, so just really brings a nice touch to it. Inside the cockpit table itself is a dedicated refrigerator. And then just forward of this is a double wine bottle holder and a little glove box. So a really nice cockpit table, very versatile, lots of cup holders. The other thing you're gonna notice at the base of the cockpit table, instead of people putting their feet on this 15 coat varnish table, you have somewhere to put your feet here, a really nice bar, support bar and grab rails when you get up. The cockpit also has LED lights throughout it to illuminate the cockpit. And the other feature that I wanted to show you guys is the halyard hanger that we installed here. This is a great touch for any vessel. When you have an area that's just not quite set up for the sheets and halyards to be stowed in, bringing in a stainless steel halyard hanger right here was a really nice touch. The rest of the sheets and halyards are all led up to the cabin top, which have designated little cubby areas. So this is a great area stowage. It keeps the cockpit really clean. So as you can see here, the strato glass itself, really nice touch. It makes it look like you're looking through a solid glass window. Just quite beautiful. The companionway hatch itself is really unique. As you can see, it's adjusted so it's just effortless to close. Very, very easy to operate. It's also counterbalanced, so if you are on a heel, there's no way that this companion hatch will ever be able to close. They do offer a lock as well too, in case you have kids and what have you. So this just slides over, locks it into place. But a great touch. Once again, solid stainless steel handrails everywhere you go. A really nice touch when you're coming down below the vessel. So as you come down below the vessel, we're going to have the nav station off to the starboard side. The nav station is quite unique. It's set up very simple in a sense. We have our E120 chart plotter here, our electrical panel here. This is a one-touch system, so I will hit this one breaker. It'll turn on all the electronics on the vessel. For all the major systems, we have all the major breakers back here for the air conditioning, chargers, and what have you. Generator controls, and this is all located back here in this nice little hidden compartment, so it's not visually in your face all the time. Tons of storage area, lots of great little cubbies found throughout. They just did a phenomenal job at this nav station. A great handhold, you know, as you're getting up or coming down the companionway steps. Everything that they thought about it, because it is a very wide beam vessel, they've really given you lots of areas to grab onto. So as you can see, we're in the galley here. We have beautiful Corian countertops, double stainless steel sinks. This is an area right here designated for all your dishes. It has a built-in drain into this as well. A beautiful European style faucet with a pull-out spigot itself. Next to the faucet is a foot pump. This is for salt water and fresh water. We have a top-loading designated freezer, and then we have a top-loading and side-loading refrigerator. New for this model year too, they've also added the stainless steel grates that pull out, so it makes it a little easier to get in and out to access all of your food in the refrigerator. Lots of cabinets found throughout. Notice that they all have the dampeners on all of the cabinet doors, whether they're up or low. Little shock absorbers. We have the microwave. We have the overhead stove hood. This does vent to the back of the boat. So, you know, you have a hood here with three settings on your fans. This is the three burner cooker. So we have three burners on the top, and then our stove and broiler found down below. And what's really unique is this, you know, Corian kind of slide-in countertop. So when you're not using this, you got any extra storage space. Additional cubbies in there, top-loading storage, our little pantry here with removable little drawers that come out. There's also lots of sub-storage, you know, down below with dedicated bins here as well. So ample amounts of storage capacity found here in the galley. Underneath the companionway steps is access to our Volkswagen 140 horsepower turbo diesel. This is a very unique engine, very, very low decibel, five cylinder, turbo diesel. It is quite impressive. The reason that Jeanneau had chosen this particular vessel is because of its very low decibel and great horsepower. As you can see here in the salon, ample amounts of light. We don't have any of the LED lighting on right now because it's just really saturated with a natural light. The table itself is quite unique. The table has an actuator, so you can actually lower it. So you turn this into a coffee table or raise it so it's up into a dinette table. Some little touches that I do for my clients, I just kind of matching their logo of their boat on some bags, hats, and jackets. Just a little nice touch from myself saying thank you. So that's what we're seeing here. The settee couch here itself also has a really nice fold-down bar. So when you're sitting here, we have a leather top area to put our drinks. And then we have wine bottle storage and glass storage, you know, built into it. We did the TV installation on this bulkhead. Thought it turned out very, very nice. We were able to bring all the cables into this back little closet area, so it limits us from having any of the chases for our wires. So it's a really nice touch to have the TV placed on this bulkhead. This is a 32-inch Samsung, by the way. We have two entryways to the staterooms up forward. Let's start out on the starboard stateroom. The starboard stateroom itself has a really nice, I would say, twin or double berth on this side. Now, one thing that this vessel possesses is when you remove the center wall, this leaf itself will lift up, and then you have a filler cushion, and you can create a queen size berth here, taking the double bunk beds that we're going to see here in a second, folding those down and creating a nice couch area, seating area with a queen size berth. So it makes this another private stateroom. As we walk up forward, you can see we have a very nice plexiglass shower divider that encapsulates the shower so you can keep the whole head dry when you're showering. We have electric Japsco Quiet Flush toilets, beautiful stainless steel sinks, and cabinet storage found throughout. So we're going to walk back into the salon here and then go into the second berth. Now we have this set up with a wall in it with the double bunk beds. So we have lots of storage, you know, found throughout, a hanging locker closet. Each one of these forward cabins has their own air conditioning and heating controls as well. When this table's closed, you have a nice little desk vanity here. And this is a little bit more set up when the bunk bed itself is folded down. So you have this forward facing little nav station or desk vanity. You have the head and shower itself. And then up all the way forward is our forward V-berth. So this can also be used as a dedicated sail locker, storage, or just a V-berth for other people in the party. Let's walk back up to the salon, and then we'll go into the aft master stateroom. The aft master stateroom on this vessel is quite unique. It is a centerline queen berth. Lots of storage, you know, found throughout. This is a dedicated foul weather gear locker, so there is a I would say a Corian type bottom to this with a drain going out. And then as we walk up forward into the aft stateroom, we're going to have our dedicated head and shower here. This too has a plexiglass door that encloses the shower itself, so it keeps the rest of the head dry. A really nice stainless steel sink, Japsco electric head again, great open ventilation found throughout, storage. And then through the rest of the aft stateroom, you're gonna see lots of just ample storage, seating areas. We have a dedicated safe that is built right into the vessel that's located down here. Lots of top shelving and so forth. The big thing to also point out is the big opening hatches. Those are escape hatches, but they really let in a lot of natural light and just really have a beautiful look to it. So in a master of this size, we have the full hanging locker. As you can see, it is quite deep. Lots of storage, lots of hidden storage in the back of this. We have louver doors. This is the upgrade with the louver doors and the teak and holly floors. Just a beautiful aft stateroom. So we're back in the salon, and this is the end to our quick video walkthrough of the 2013 Jeanneau 57. I hope you found this helpful and informative. If you have any questions about the Jeanneau product, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. My number is 619-507-4416. Thank you again, and I look forward to hearing from you.